Today's experiment is sponsored by HelloFresh. Hey guys, I'm Nate. Welcome back to the workshop. A lot of people have commented asking us to make some ice cream using liquid nitrogen. So today, that's what we're going to do in a few different varieties. In the past, Grant has shown you how to make some futuristic ice cream beads by melting existing ice cream, putting it into a little squeeze container, and then dripping that out into liquid nitrogen. Today, we'll show you a recipe you can use instead of melting existing ice cream, and we'll make both the futuristic bead style ice cream and regular ice cream. Here we have a lot of equipment and ingredients to make our ice cream, and I'll go over each aspect of it as we get to it. Let's start by making our Dippin' Dots styled ice cream. The recipe is very basic. We'll start with 1/2 cup of milk and 1/2 cup of half and half. My 1 cup measuring cup is conveniently divided in the center at the 1/2 cup mark, so I can just fill to one line with the half and half and then finish filling it with the milk. Now let's see if I have a steady enough hand to pour the milk and the half and half into the bottle from our measuring cup. Not so much. You know, I'm actually gonna blame the measuring cup for this one. It doesn't pour very well. This is also a very clean, new plate, so I'm just gonna pour it straight from the plate into the bottle. See, why does a folded plate work better than the pouring spout on the measuring cup? With our milk and half combined in our squeeze bottle, it's time to add 1/4 cup of sugar and a dash of vanilla extract. But this is gonna pour just about as well as the milk. About the same. All right, close our top. And then we're just gonna stir this around. We want the sugar to completely dissolve into the liquid. It can take a while for all of the sugar to dissolve because our milk and half are quite cold, and sugar doesn't dissolve as quickly in cold liquid. Looking at the bottom, it's hard to see, but you can kind of make out grains on the bottom of sugar if there's too much of it. I'm just trying to stir it up until there are no more. All right, I think most of my sugar is dissolved. Let's see how this is tasting before I freeze it. I'm just gonna drip a little bit out onto my finger here. Tastes really good. It's got a good vanilla flavor. It's nice and sweet, nice and creamy. Now what we need to do is freeze this into our ice cream beads. I have here a stack of styrofoam plates, which should insulate pretty well. I'm going to fill one of these plates with liquid nitrogen so I have a nice shallow surface to drip our ice cream mixture onto so we don't end up piling all of our ice cream beads in one spot. Let's see if I'm able to pour straight onto this plate. Ooh, our plate changes shape a little bit as it gets cold. That's exciting. There we go. It's a nice layer of liquid nitrogen there. Plates have settled back down to the shape they were originally. Now let's see what happens if we just drip in a little bit at a time our ice cream mixture. Some of our ice cream beads have frozen just slightly to the plate beneath it, but just a little bit of pressure and they sort of pop right off. There we go, milk, half and half, sugar, and vanilla dripped into some liquid nitrogen, and we have our futuristic ice cream bead dessert. These things are really good. A word of caution though, when they first come out of the liquid nitrogen, they are unbelievably cold, and if you eat them right away, they will stick to the inside of your mouth and burn it with the cold. If it's cold enough to stick to water on your finger, it will stick to your tongue and hurt. Don't do it. Once it's warmed up enough that it's not going to stick to the inside of your mouth, enjoy a delicious and very interesting textured dessert.
It's really good.
It is a lot more effort than just scooping ice cream out of the carton, but it's a lot cooler. And I mean that in both ways. Our dessert today is brought to us by liquid nitrogen, but the rest of our meal is going to be delivered to us by HelloFresh. Let's take just a moment to look at how their service works. If you like to cook at home, HelloFresh is a great way to do it. They've really set up a system that's convenient to use. If you have a busy schedule, you can choose the delivery day that works best for you. If you're going to be out of town, you can pause your account for weeks at a time. All of the ingredients come pre-measured in handy labeled meal kits, so you know which ingredients go with which recipe, unlike at a grocery store. And of course, the whole kit is delivered right to your door in recyclable, insulated packaging. HelloFresh offers a wide variety of chef-curated recipes that are different every week. They have the classic, veggie, and family plans to choose from. The recipes are designed to only take about 30 minutes to prep, so you're not gonna have to spend all night in the kitchen cooking. Several of the meals are designed to be one-pot recipes for speedy cooking and minimal cleanup. Each week, one meal in the classic menu is designed to only take 20 minutes to prep. This was my first time trying one of these services that delivers meals with all of the recipes and ingredients included. I thought the instructions were easy to follow, prep time was quick, and the quality of the food was excellent. It's a really convenient and easy service to use, knowing that you're getting full meals in just the right portion sizes. For $30 off your first week of HelloFresh, visit HelloFresh.com and enter promo code KingOfRandom30. Dinner was great, now let's focus back on the desserts. Using our milk, our half and half, a little bit of sugar, and a dash of vanilla, we were able to make a delicious vanilla-flavored ice cream beads dessert. But I want to try adding a few different flavors to see if we can mix it up a little. Rather than using regular milk, I'm going to try making an eggnog and a chocolate version of our Dippin' Dots style ice cream. Let's try the eggnog first. Half cup eggnog. I'll try pouring this, well, it's just half full to see if it'll pour better that way. Yep. Half a cup of eggnog, half a cup of half and half, and 1/4 cup of sugar. Should just pour the sugar directly onto the plate and then use the plate to pour it into the bottle. I think I will do that next time. I'm not adding any vanilla extract this time because I think the eggnog will provide all the flavor we need. We do have to mix it up and get that sugar dissolving though. Now I think a great flavor to go with our eggnog is going to be hot chocolate flavor. Of course, it's going to be cooled down a lot, so it's not going to have the heat of hot cocoa, but it will have the flavor of hot cocoa. So to do that, I have some chocolate milk and I've taken our half and half and I've mixed in a bunch of cocoa powder. Cocoa powder does not usually dissolve well in cold liquids, so I did heat up the half and half, then I mixed in the cocoa powder, and then I cooled it down in the refrigerator until it was about room temperature. Now we'll follow our same recipe, but instead of using milk and half, we'll use chocolate milk and chocolate half and half. Should be pretty good. Let's see, I don't know how well this cup pours, but not too bad. Here we go, chocolate milk and half turned into hot chocolate. This should be delicious. Now, as delicious as that is, ice cream is supposed to be a very sweet dessert, so I'm still going to add a little bit of sugar to this. Not a full 1/4 cup like I have for the others, but a little bit, maybe 1/8 cup. There we go, we now have our eggnog and our hot chocolate flavored ice cream mixes. So let's pour a couple of plates of liquid nitrogen and start dripping. Eggnog and hot chocolate ice cream beads.
That's a really good combo.
There you go, a couple of recipes on how to make eggnog and hot chocolate flavored futuristic ice cream beads. These things are really good. It's a good flavor combination too, eggnog and hot chocolate. I noticed when dripping our ice cream formula into the liquid nitrogen, it would take a second or two for the individual beads to begin to freeze. And if one drip touched another drip before it had the chance to freeze, they would join together. And then you just get a larger ice cream bead instead of two small ones. Whether or not that's a good thing might be up to you. I generally tried to get the small beads, but if I was getting a couple that were made of 2 or even 3 drops, I didn't really worry about it. All right, now we know how to make our futuristic Dippin' Dots style ice cream. Let's move on to making some regular styled ice cream. For our more stereotypically textured ice cream, we're gonna try a slightly different recipe of 1/2 cup half and half and 1/2 cup heavy cream. We'll still also add 1/4 cup of sugar and a dash of vanilla. Now let's stir this up until all of the sugar is dissolved. we can't really see the sugar very well the same way we could in the squeeze bottle. Since we won't be able to see the sugar very well, we'll need to rely on the sound and feel of the spatula to know when our sugar is dissolved. There we go, I think our sugar is now completely dissolved into our mixture, so it's time to start adding the cold. Let's pour our liquid nitrogen into our measuring cup and then carefully pour from there into our mixture and then start stirring it around. I'm only adding about a quarter of a cup of the liquid nitrogen at a time. You can see that the nitrogen gets inside of the cream mixture and makes it bubble up quite a bit. Stopped hissing. I think that means all of the nitrogen is gone and it's time to add more. Ooh, we're looking really good now. That's definitely starting to look like ice cream. As I'm stirring, I'm trying to keep the liquid nitrogen and the ice cream off the walls of the bowl as much as I can, because if the liquid nitrogen stays in contact with the metal, it will create really cold points, and then we'll have super frozen bits of ice cream on the sides, but not as much in the middle. Beautiful. That is looking like ice cream. It's a little bit soft. If you like your ice cream harder, I'd say you can just keep adding a little bit more liquid nitrogen to cool it down even further. I kind of like slightly soft ice cream personally. Let's have a war in the comments section about which is better, hard ice cream or soft ice cream. But a polite war. A nice, gentle, kindly spoken war. That right there, I think, is ice cream ready to serve. Let's try some of this. That's really good. That is very good. Unbelievably creamy. I guess 75% of this recipe is cream, so it makes sense that it would be really creamy. Scoop out our ice cream, and I think we are ready to serve. Our recipe for vanilla ice cream worked great, so let's see if we can add a few more things and give ourselves a little bit different flavor. This time I'm gonna try for caramel, and then I'm gonna see if I can make some raspberry ice cream with real raspberries. Just add a little bit of this. I'm not sure how powerful it is. Then I also have some caramel sauce that's meant for ice cream. And once I've got the ice cream a little bit frozen, I'll swirl in some caramel sauce and then freeze it even more. Just stirring to dissolve all the sugar. There we go, our ice cream is now at a pretty good consistency. I'm gonna add some caramel and then just try and freeze it up a little bit more with our caramel gently swirled in. Beautiful. Got streaks of caramel. It's not so mixed in that you don't see it anymore. And then, of course, it's caramel flavored to begin with. It's really good stuff. Super creamy. This has turned out great. Let's try raspberry. Not really sure exactly how much of that to add. This is going to be raspberry flavored ice cream, so let's add a drop of red to turn our ice cream pink. Perfect. We've got some nice raspberries that we're going to add into our ice cream, but unfortunately they thawed a little bit more than they were supposed to. So they're very mushy, and I'm afraid if I try and mix them in like this, we'll just have like a puree, and we kind of want the chunks of raspberry instead. So to fix that, I'm just gonna take a little bit of liquid nitrogen, pour that over the raspberries, and hope that solidifies them so that they'll mix into the ice cream a little bit nicer. Scrape our raspberries and our liquid nitrogen just down into the bowl. That is looking like some delicious raspberry ice cream. Ooh, very good. Lots of good creamy flavor, of course, some good raspberry flavor, and a little bit of a tart kick from the actual raspberry mixed in. This is delicious. There you have it, milk, cream, half and half, and some liquid nitrogen, and several delicious recipes for ice cream. These are all seriously very good. So we have our standard vanilla, we've got our raspberry with actual raspberries in it, and we have our caramel flavor with caramel swirls in it, which is also fantastic. Our standard style ice cream was made by mixing up our cream and our half and half, and then adding liquid nitrogen to that while we stirred it. Our Dippin' Dots style ice cream was made by slowly squeezing out a mixture of milk and half with some sugar and flavoring at it into the liquid nitrogen, so it formed nice little ice cream beads. With our standard ice cream recipe, if you do want it to be a little lower fat, you can substitute the half and half and cream for milk and half. This will cut down on the fat a lot, and if you're using liquid nitrogen, it's still gonna freeze and get pretty solid. It won't taste quite as creamy, but it'll still be quite delicious. Thanks for joining us for this video today, and remember to come gear yourself up with hats, shirts, and other cool merchandise at thekingofrandom.com. See you there.
Yes, this workbench is clean enough to eat off of. Why do you ask?
I don't know about you, but I'm gonna feel really fat by the end of the day. I don't look it, but I'm gonna feel it. Very cool.
Cool.
I've used that pun like 12 times today already. There we go, our ice cream made with liquid nitrogen and our dinner provided by HelloFresh. To try out their service, head to HelloFresh.com and enter promo code KingOfRandom30 for $30 off of your first week of food.